In 1934, Plymouth Church merged with the neighboring Church of the Pilgrims, the first congregational church in Brooklyn, becoming Plymouth Church of the Pilgrims. Organized in 1844, Church of the Pilgrims had as its founding pastor Richard Salter Storrs, who served the church until 1900. Like Beecher, Storrs was one of the most famous clergymen in America, known as a thinker, writer, and orator of note. Selected as Brooklyn's keynote speaker at the dedication of the Brooklyn Bridge in 1883, Storrs was also a trustee of Amherst College and president of both the Long Island Historical Society, now known as the Brooklyn Historical Society, and the American Historical Association. The stained glass windows of Plymouth Church are widely recognized as artistic treasures. The prominent artist Frederick Stuymetz Lamb designed, and his brothers of the J&R Lamb Studios in Greenwich Village built, the 19 major windows of the sanctuary, installed between 1907 and 1909. As planned by then-Minister Newell Dwight Hillis, they are unusual in depicting historical, not religious, subjects, taking as their theme the influence of Puritanism, the parent of Congregationalism, on the growth of liberty in the United States, personal liberty, religious liberty, and political liberty. Joining these masterworks in nearby Hillis Hall are the original windows from Church of the Pilgrims, including three signed by Lewis C. Tiffany and one from Tiffany Studios, transferred to Plymouth when the two churches merged in 1934. Several windows, including a noteworthy Ascension on the north wall, were created by Otto Heinigke, a leading glass artist of the early 20th century, and creator of the mosaics in the lobby of the Woolworth Building in Manhattan. In 1867, a group from the church undertook a 5.5-month voyage aboard the steamer Quaker City to Europe and the Holy Land. Joining them as a journalist was the young Mark Twain. His satiric account of this pioneering tour group, The Innocents Abroad, was Twain's best-selling work throughout his lifetime. Twain spoke at Plymouth, as did many other famous writers and activists, including Clara Barton, Charles Dickens, Ralph Waldo Emerson, Horace Greeley, and William Thackeray. More recently, in February 1963, Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. preached a sermon on the American Dream, echoed just months later in his famous, "I Have a Dream," speech in Washington, D.C.